Back, we are here. The grand final. Saviz and Tice. Saviz has been on some ridiculous, like, best of fives. I mean, I think every single match he's had has been five games long, right? Like, the last one, it was Top Deck War, which he barely managed to win against Super JJ. It was the DC best of five victory against...
Kalento.
Against Kalento and against Amnesiac.
Yeah, man. And he also, I don't know how his series went against RD. I can't remember off the top of my head. But
that may have been a little
close. Actually, I think that was a 3-1.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think you're right.
I don't think that was very close. But he's made it, and he's done it doing his own unique style with the Priest deck. That's definitely the oddball in. Tice, in the meantime, has a team style, the G2. It feels appropriate that G2 seems to have found something unique with the format, with the Priest and the Warrior, and that one of them has made it to the finals. And who else but their flagship trademark consistent player from 2015. I mean, Life Coach was great at the beginning of 2015, but when you think about last year in retrospect, people pick up Tice as one of the top three players who made a notable impression for his results.
Absolutely. It's great to see them here. Let's see, how do these decks match up? I feel like this G2 lineup of decks has mostly profited off the fact that almost everybody has brought this aggro shaman deck. Everybody has brought this druid deck, but the druid deck just wasn't really that easily countered. But it seems like their lineup just does well enough against shaman to kind of punish it. They're playing kind of like, you know, they're playing druid because it's like the almost unbeatable class, and then the other two are like the punish. So it's like the hybrid of bringing your best decks versus bringing the counter comp.
Yeah, it's a good point. It's like a clash of the meta versus the next level if trying to beat it. Sometimes you go a little bit too far with trying to counter what's popular, and you end up weakening your entire lineup. But it's, I don't know if that's the case here. I think Tice would much rather face against Savitz's Priest than the Rogues, because I think the Rogue is the one that gives a real problematic fit to Tice's Priest and his Warrior. However, I don't know. Like, Savitz's Priest, every time I underestimate it, it seems to have the right draws with the right combos. Or his opponent mysteriously leaves right when he's about to lose otherwise. So, you know, hopefully that's not the case here. I'm pretty sure that, you know, Amaz and crew put in a work order to have backup power to the entire city of Enskede so Tice doesn't have his internet disconnect like he did in day number one.
Yeah, I'm not so sure about that. But all right, hopefully none of that does happen. It is going to be a druid mirror. Looks like Tice has... what I would consider the better opener. Oh, maybe not anymore. Looks like they both have some real, I don't know what they call those, sinkers. They just do nothing for most of the game.
Well, they trade. That's basically what it is. The Darnassus Aspirant will warrant your opponent to definitely clear it.
Yeah,
that's going to reset his board, and he can't do anything the following turn.
I was referring to these like huge minions, like... there's a 7 and a 6 in, I think it's Saviz's hand. He's got the 6, 7, 8 Tice.
That's true. And they're very similar, too, in what they try to accomplish. So, we'll see. I mean, I still do like having more card draw than my opponent if I'm playing the Druid matchups, just because... the Ancient of Lore can outvalue over time some of these minions. It can trade with minions, and then you'll still have two more. Versus if for some reason someone can deal with your Ancient of War, silence it, for example, and then kill it, you're just out. So I also like that Savitz is on an additional mana. Assuming that Darnassus dies, but him going first is a big deal to play threats pretty proactively and threaten whatever Tice plays reactively.
Mm-hmm. He's going to play a bit passively, though. He's going to give respect to a potential 5 drop from the bonus mana crystal and the coin of Tice. Instead of playing his own 3 drop, but that seems acceptable as he doesn't have a 4 drop either. So he's not really giving up much. And Tice drawn pretty badly yet again, but the Farseer, why not?
It's his best play. I mean, even if he had a four drop, I think he would still consider playing the Farseer so he can play, use the coin pretty effectively. As long as he has something to do next turn, he has an opportunity to coin a Thorazine on 5 and then hit the Ancient of War on 6, Ragnaros on 7.
Mm-hmm.
So that's going to be the plan for Tice. Just draw something playable. Meanwhile, Savitz is going to be on the plan of just like making sure that he has something to play every turn as well.
Oh! That Emperor. That's a turn 9, 22-er.
Yeah.
And it's gone.
Yeah.
I had my hopes up.
It makes sense to use it now, just because, again, he wants to coin Emperor, but you are right. It would be a 22 Wombo for 9 mana.
All right. Well, nobody's going to be playing Secrets from what we know.
No.
Kind of like the five face.
Pretty impossible to get Secrets. Not unlikely. Not the most impossible, but it's extremely unlikely. I think, yeah, in the end, whether or not you attack here, you could be missing 5 damage, which is very relevant.
I think the main consideration was in regard to keeping his Emperor safe.
Yeah, but he can do it next turn as well. The best way to remove it is the Keeper of the Grove tempo. Otherwise, if your opponent used Wrath, you only had 3 more mana to use.
Mm-hmm. Well, there's no swipe in Saviz's hand yet, but that would be a pretty brutal card.
Yeah, swipe would be such clean removal, giving you enough mana to also develop other stuff. Oh, man. You can play your own Emperor and then innervate clear on the Emperor Thorazine on the other side. So that's something that sticks out to me immediately. However, you
could
still
play Sylvanas.
Farseer.
I don't think Sylvanas is bad. Sylvanas just prompts the trade.
What I feel like you're also asking to get blown out by Keeper of the Grove.
Oh, yeah. Also, you die to innervate. That's a fun fact.
That is fun, Crip. Very fun.
25.
I think because of the size of your hand and that you have cards like Living Roots being 0, I think it's okay to trade here and try to put the onus back on your opponent to clear.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he still can't clear very cleanly.
I think you just don't clear. I think you Ancient of War and prep for combo next turn.
Well, now you can. You can Azure Drake.
Oh, yeah, that is pretty good.
For 2. But
man,
you're right. If you play
Ancient of War plays so good.
You're absolutely right, actually. If it sets up for a Force of Nature Savage Roar the next turn. That's really interesting. And it's innocuous enough where it's like you don't really expect it.
Mm-hmm.
Because the thing is, some plays are really obvious, you know? Like when you swipe face when there's like a 4 health target in front of you.
Yeah.
But
exactly.
In this case, it's still pretty sneaky. It looks like, should I leave it up? Should I? I'll just play this on curve. And Zavitz is about to get a pretty big surprise.
Yeah, this Sylvanas is a death sentence. There is no way he can stay alive if he plays Sylvanas.
Well, actually, there's just no way he can there's just no way he can really survive. You're right. There's like I was just thinking like he has to heal, right, and then Living Roots.
Right.
That's the only way he can survive. So that's gonna wrap it up. And Tice with the 2-turn lethal spot. This was one of the difference makers. That, we saw Life Coach, his teammate,
mm-hmm.
opt to not do something like this and end up punishing him. And I think Tice, this is something that he's recognized a lot because he's played Druid
so
often.
It is a difference in playstyle that I've noticed that Life Coach would play around more cards than most people can imagine. He usually plays around stuff that takes us a while to see when we can see both hands.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's his, like, his strength, that's his forte. While Tice, gets himself involved in a lot of situations that have complicated multiple turn lethals that I feel is very distinct between the two players. Both are very successful styles, though.
Yeah. It's working out really good for Tice, though. He's up 1-0, and his Druid's out of the way. I wonder if Savisi is just going to stick on Druid, get the win, and then reset us to see which is better between the Shaman Priest and the Priest Warrior.
It's going to be Shaman from Savisi, in fact. Harrison, you tempted to keep that?
I am, but I'm only tempted if I have a good curve and I'm on the coin, which he happens to have.
So I think he just kept every card, by the way.
Yeah. Yeah, when you play... Because Harrison these days are played in Control Priest. I think Colento was climbing to rank 2 repeatedly, hitting it over and over and over and over. And he put Harrison in his deck to really kill a lot of the Paladins. But one of the rules that I remember that was being discussed is you should keep Harrison if you think it's a really important card, only if you have the coin and you're on curve. Mm-hmm. But this happens to be a pretty nice curve. 2-5, even splits. And you even have opportunities to draw into more stuff. The only caveat is that Twilight Guardian doesn't have a dragon for itself to activate, but I'm sure you'll pick it up within the next 3 draws or so.
Mm-hmm. I feel like Tice is in a very good position here. With these two decks and the Shaman not having won any games, and I mean, I hate to call it early, but it doesn't look like he's going to be winning this game.
I mean, you can just say someone's favored. You don't have to say it's over. You can say heavily favored.
I think he is very heavily favored. Wow, even with a Northshire, it's further punishing the options.
Is someone injured?
Yeah, that means you're not forced to use the coin immediately, giving yourself further options to explore. Mm-hmm. One thing to consider is that Harrison Jones might not actually have impact if Shaman never draws Doomhammer.
But can Shaman win without drawing Doomhammer in this situation?
It's a good question. One that I'm not personally prepared to answer, Crip, so I'm just going to let Savitz answer that. Because he's the one who has to deal with it ultimately.
Okay. Well, the Wormhearth Agent does a pretty good job here. Can Lava Shock and Lightning Bolt just to push for more and more damage?
Yep, try to get more out of your minions, except his minions are going to be met by a wall known as the Twilight Guardian. And the Twilight Guardian is going to be so good because not only will you have minions crashing on it, but you'll also have the Farseer to bounce it back up in health.
I think he might Farseer here.
Yeah, Farseer also does have some validity, but the taunt directly translates to health. Mm-hmm. Versus the Farseer is going to just make your opponent attack into your face anyways.
Yeah.
So it's like a temporary stall versus this is a hard stall. They actually just can't attack. Well, I mean, they could, but do you want to put all of the damage into the 3-6?
Mm-hmm.
It's tough.
It's got to do it. There's no way around it right now. There's no more spells. He's used all of those. There's no Earthshock or anything yet. It would have been interesting to save the coin is why I suggested the Farseer play, because you would then play the taunt the turn after, then you'd have the coin for turn 5 with the Cabal. I feel like the game really like ends when the Cabal hits on the good minion. It's just such a swing.
It's right. Horse Riders are great. Feral Spirits are awesome. Even when you like land it on other stuff that you don't really expect it, like Leopard Gnomes. It can really swing how things are going. Ban Bronzebeard, another intimidating card. It's not directly...
Whoa!
It's not directly the threat, but what it can combine with is good. He needs 2 juggles. Onto Bran.
Or face. I think double face is alright as well, because Bran cannot challenge these taunts. I'm actually thinking Saviz has pulled it back. I think he might be the favored right now.
Well, you can heal for 8, and there's... How much onto the board right now? 5, 7, 7, 9. So, it's not impossible. It's like we were saying, though. Just because you have Harrison doesn't mean that you're guaranteed to win.
That was an anti-heal bot, I just noticed. I guess a little bit better.
Whoa. Wow. Two more. Add those to the count. Bran is taking damage. So those splits allowing you to kill Bran if you want to. I don't think he feels like he can afford to. Savitz is targeting the face. The best he would probably trade in is maybe one of the wolves, but he doesn't want to weaken his board to Holy Nova anymore.
Yeah. Pyro, but no spells. You gotta do Cabal.
Shadow Priest. Let me change your mind. Hit the 2-1 and really hope that your opponent doesn't have any more Doom Hammer off the top.
On curve.
I think that might seal it. It's on the mana curve, but it's, I don't know. It's allowing him to put 7 more damage. But that damage still seems very far away.
Thinking about killing Bran here. I think it's a good consideration. Because doubling another heal battle cry might actually be a bit of an issue.
I don't know. I have to think that you're... Oh, you know what? I'm thinking about if Savitz expects his Doomhammer to get Harrisoned. I mean, this is because you're playing as if it doesn't exist. Here's another thing, though. Harrison costs 5 out of 7 mana. With 2 mana remaining, you have to pick up cards like Holy Smite. Boom! He's not happy to see that at all, but he still knows that there's a
draws. There are 2 Holy Smites in this deck. Let's see if they're drawn. That's a 1 drop. That's not a great one.
Oh!
One of them.
Ooh. That was so important. The last draw possible.
And the Twilight Well to push for more board. Okay, 8 damage short. Oh, that's a blunder. That's just nothing.
It's nothing. It's to get past a taunt if he has some kind of damage, but he'd rather just have damage. It probably is just going to use Holy Nova and Farseers and that kind of stuff to heal back up right now. You just need to stay alive. What is your opponent not able to play for 6 mana in his deck? I would say absolutely nothing.
Mm-hmm.
So he has to be holding situational removal, right?
Yeah, I think Tice might do a Farseer taunt play. That's what he's thinking about, doing that versus the Holy Nova. The Holy Nova seems like the obvious choice. He might do the Holy Nova and the Farseer, just to push himself as far as possible. Yep.
I like it. It also sets up lethal for the following turn. And can Savitz come back? No, the Totem Golem. Just too weak at this point. I mean, it's just too weak on the tempo. Even if it was a huge minion like Fellreaver, wouldn't do anything. Because he's just dead on the board.
Savitz has to kill the Drake just to not be dead on the board. But there's plenty of damage coming. Dice has an additional 5 in hand right now.
Cabal the spell power totem and shoot him for 3 on the Holy Smite. That's what I say.
Wow, that's a weak BM. Is that right,
okay,
though?
Okay,
BM doesn't win tournaments.
Crip, you have 10 seconds to one-up me.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Oh, it's all blurred! The screen is blurred! You can't see!
I don't think I could one-up you. That was a good BM. I meant his BM was weak.
Okay.
Your suggestion was good, I think.
I appreciate that.
All right, well, Tice is on Warrior, a spot we've seen him a few times already. Well, I have to say, I think this Warrior's going to get dunked pretty hard by that Druid. I think that Druid is particularly good against this Warrior with Sylvanas, and I think Harrison's also in there. I think the Priest is going to destroy the Warrior in most games. But I have a feeling this Shaman is really going to struggle to pull out against this Warrior if it even comes to that.
If it comes out to that. I mean, that's a opening hand where it's okay for Druid. You got the Mounted Raptor, which is sticky. You've got Emperor Thorsen early on, which is great. But if Warrior can pick up a single dragon, I would say that it has a decent amount of removal options early on.
I like nice the living draw. Here. Yeah. I'm a big fan of saving at least one innervate for Emperor. I mean, you have good 4-drops in this deck, but they're not active. Like, you have a Savage Combatant, which is a great 4-drop, but you feel bad just playing it on turn 4. So yeah. I think nothing is really going to beat a innervate Tharson on 4.
Oh, okay, you might be innervate the Drake?
Yep.
Okay. It makes sense, he has the 3-drop following up, wants to keep up the pressure. He doesn't want to pass to the Alexstrasza as his champion, let it just seize the board. Warax is awkward.
Yeah, it's almost good. I think in this spot you might just play the monkey out and worry about removing stuff next turn.
If you play the Fierce Monkey, you have access to 4 mana next turn. It still doesn't improve your removal options on 4 mana. That's like the really awkward thing, too. Alright, Fierce Monkey coming down. He has 2 of them, so it's better to get it down anyways. You're absolutely right. Mounted Raptor, one of the stickier minions as well. So that card's really complicated for Warax to trade into.
Yeah. But it can do it. I'm wondering how much health Tice is willing to leverage here. He might do a greedy trade onto the 1-1 with the Armorsmith and the Warax on the 4-1. Just to keep another minion.
I think so. I think minions fighting minions is the way you can win in the long term as the warrior, because you need them to fight and scale, so that way you're not taking the big hits from the Ancient of Wars and the Ancient of Lores. Plus, an Armorsmith is so nice with more minions on board. It's great. Okay, well, Living Roots is something to do. You can kill the Armorsmith and play Living Roots. It's almost certainly that you want to kill the Armorsmith before anything else. Card's so problematic.
I think you've seen this Warrior deck enough already. Like, there are no Whirlwind effects. I think it's good enough to just play Living Roots as 1-1s. That surprises me.
This is interesting.
Very aggressive.
Especially because it's like he has Living Roots. So he's using Living Roots after he uses Savage Roar to clear the board, and he doesn't have Savage Roar. But I think he's recognizing his hand is pretty awkward.
He can so shield Tice. Slam. Tice can is shield really slam and monkey.
He's just gonna armor up. He wants to use Bash and Seal Slam in tandem. Voidwalker not really that great as it should be, even though that's usually a much higher than average 1-drop.
That's an okay draw.
I must save. Yeah, so Druid's gonna need a lot of help from Ancient of Lore in the coming turns. The hand's not terribly impressive to close the game out, but Warrior's also floundering.
Sneeze a dragon. Sneeze a dragon. Oh, no dragon. The dragon would have been sick because it would have basically blocked the Tharson. Kill the 1-3, the 2-4 doesn't challenge it. Play Tharson into a situation where he dies straight out with 3 cards in hand. It's marginal.
Yeah, he still had an option of playing the Blackwing Corruptor. But I can understand why he wants the value off of it. And here we go. Is it the parade for Savitz to start making the comeback? His opponent had a very weak turn, producing some pretty effective cards with the Ancient of Lore. And the only way to remove it is to bash Hero Power Shield Slam, and that happens to be 6 mana. Oh,
that's good.
Interesting. Now you might not need to even use Bash. You can just slam, pick up a dragon, kill the 5-3 with the Blackwing Corruptor.
That'd be ridiculous. Oh, he got it! He got it! That was huge! Slam into dragon had to be the best sequencing of draws there.
Yeah. It's also a playable dragon, too. It's not like something that he has to wait till turn 9 or and hope that his board's okay. Well, that garden's usually very good. So the wrath.
Yeah, you can wrath for you can wrath for one and savage combatant kill that. Then the keeper kills a 3/2.
I like it a lot. You don't have to worry too much about trading with your health. It's very clear this deck's not running some kind of Gromash, Alex Straza combo finishers. Mm-hmm. Maintain board control.
When those big minions do come down, MC Tech is his only defense, though.
Oh, man.
That sucks.
It's just full of awkwardness. The bashes... 3 damage. The shield slam off the bash is 3 damage, and you would have to armor up to do it.
Yeah. He's going to do it, though. There's no doubt.
Yeah. I think one thing you have to consider is that you can't take that damage from the minions. It's just too much to absorb every turn.
Mm-hmm.
You know, as 7 damage is on the board, it's just going to get worse.
It's reasonable, though. I mean, this Twilight Guardian is not even that great without the Battlecry being able to trigger from the hold mechanic, so I don't think you're losing much by holding it another turn.
Yep, touche.
You're really just, I mean, you have like 2 or 3 nine drops. I think it's 3 nine drops and a 10 drop. You just have to draw one of those. That's it. That's the game. Get one of those.
Ysarion, Nepharion. Sorry, Ysarion. Ysera, Nepharion.
Anixion, Varian.
Varian.
It's crazy value to each of them.
Oh yeah, we saw the Varian Dream. It happened. Pulled 3 minions onto the battlefield. It's awesome.
Oh.
Okay. I mean, here's the thing. You're getting by with removal, but it's just barely, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And nice. Druid's still gonna keep its foot on the pedal. They're putting the Druid in a position where it has to draw into lethal is gonna be really dangerous to fight back from. Very close to an unreal turn. If he was able to play Azure Drake, Innervate, Ancient of War, mm-hmm. that would have been sealed. Here's a question, would you uproot this?
No, 3 damage is too common. But I would definitely not trade. I think I would have picked up by now that there is no execute.
He used both bashes, a shield slam, and a slam.
Yeah.
He's not going to uproot, but is there any world where where $12,000 wasn't on the line, would you uproot?
No, I don't think so. But I do very much approve of not trading the 3/3s. Hello.
Oh man. I think it's time to forget the synergies with the Twilight Guardian as Goku. Yeah.
Well, a swipe could easily take care of this. He has 2 chances for a swipe.
You first have to get the swipe, and what are the chances of those, Crip?
Well, we're gonna try again here, I believe.
Yeah, you can cycle the Wild Growth, unless he wants to keep the Innervate or something else.
I think the Innervate is not really worth much after this turn. So I think you basically Innervate to draw another card. And if you don't get anything good, you taunt the Druid of the Claw.
What to do?
I agree. I don't think there's actually too much value. It's not like you can silence something and then force a Nature Savage where you need to have Emperor Thorsen hit some of those cards in order to get the benefit of it. The Innervate also has benefits from using a 2 Savage Roars, but Tice already used 1 in the early game, so it's not looking likely that he'll be able to benefit off of... Oh, sorry, Savitz used 1 early, not Tice. Tice is the warrior player.
Yeah.
Okay. By the way, kind of funny that he played Mind Control Tech, and then Nyxia followed up with it.
Well. Okay.
Double Dragons.
I guess you could play 1.
You could argue you could play 2. He doesn't have many dragon.
Oh yeah, I think you do play. I think you do play 2.
The only one I believe might be a second Blackwing Corruptor, which is 1 out of, I don't know, 14 cards at best.
Yeah. It's not really worth anything at this stage.
Would you use your weapon at all here? Probably not.
No, you're probably going to get a chance to next turn. You only have one charge anyway.
He's thinking about it.
You don't have to worry about MC Tech if you trade. That's another plus.
But when you see Mountain Raptor in an MC Tech, do you expect two MC Techs?
I have a sneaky suspicion that you might have two MC Techs. But we've just seen it so frequently. I don't think we've ever seen two in one game, but we've seen MC Tech in every game.
You've been burned too many times, Grip.
Yeah.
The trauma is so real. Oh, gosh. Another bad draw here. Wild Growth still at least giving him ability to cycle. Imagine if Wild Growth couldn't cycle.
Oh, well, is that it?
Wait, that is that it?
Like it?
Oh
that
my
looks
god.
Like it might be.
Wait. No, he's one
no,
off.
No, it's not. It's not.
He has 19.
Yeah, he has 19. That's right.
He was so ready to commit to it, too. It was so awkward if he ended up playing it. He could also sit to clear, right?
No, I think you could just commit to it now, give the warrior to one. Because then he has Keeper and then Hero Power. It's not like there's more taunts in this deck. He's gone through two Monkeys and two Twilight Guardians, right?
Yeah, but you also know that there's like shield block in this deck too. I think you just clear and then try to ride the minions a little bit more.
Yeah, probably.
There's actually, I think it's still completely okay. Warrior's out of cards. And you know what card you would really want right around now? Probably want Varian Wrynn. Except you use your monkeys. What kind of taunts do you have?
No, you don't have anything. That's what I was saying. I think you have no taunts left. That's why I don't think Tice can come back this game.
He needed shield block. Shield block into the Armorsmith.
It had to be something better than that. But yeah, shield block into something would have been good.
All right, death it is. Speed stays alive in the series, but it would have been just a one-sided thrashing if he was not able to win Druid versus the Warrior.
Mm-hmm. My guess is that Saviz is going to continue to try to get as much information as possible. I think Saviz is going to go Priest here, and I think the Priest is very good against this Warrior deck. Much like the Druid, the minions are hard to remove. Oh no, it is going to be Shaman!
It also could be a comfort thing. Maybe Saviz doesn't feel like his priest is just reliable as mm-hmm. he'd like it to be, but it's worked out okay. Well, he still needs to win with both decks either way.
Yeah. Yeah, Saviz has had a few inconsistent experiences with the priest, but the few times it has worked, the deck is pretty spectacular.
Not exactly the cards to follow up turn one for the Shaman, but the Warrior isn't exactly in the most comfy of boats either. Needs to pick up some weapons. Throws away a Farseer even, so that way he has a higher likelihood of picking up a weapon.
It's really all about the War Axe. I think he mulliganed away to Shield Slam, drew the other Shield Slam, and the first card was the first Shield Slam that he mulliganed out. That's pretty bad.
Yeah, definitely. It's not ideal whatsoever.
That's also terrible. I think you have to armor up here.
You don't slam here to draw a card? I mean, you do miss the two health, but your hand's pretty bad, I think. I'd consider it, at least.
Yeah. Yeah, you have to consider it. But I feel like the slam is better used to kill a juggler behind taunts.
Yep. Also completely fair. You don't have bash, so you can't really play around something like that. Abusive Sergeants adding 5 damage. I like it. Your opponent didn't show an ability to deal with the board, so just go for it.
Oh, this is pretty crazy. That monkey is going to get destroyed by that lava burst. Oh! Oh, can we do this? Is it going to happen? Cruel task? Oh, no.
No, he's going for the monkey. That's going to cause a lava burst.
Lava monkey. Here we go.
Well, you don't have to. You can use Coin Rock Biter now. I mean, Lava Burst is very clean removal, though.
I like the Lava Burst a little bit more. But they're both very good.
Let's see. If you use a 2 overload, you're going to have 2 mana next turn. So you can coin Feral Spirits the following turn if you Lava Burst now. But you lose out the 4 damage that you get from the Feral Spirits. It's hard. You're trading in the Rock Biter, which could give you maximum 6 damage right now to give you an extra 4. But if the Feral Spirits hit 2 turns, then it's worth it. It's actually more damage. It's 1.5 turns of effect.
If you play the Rock Biter, you have to lose a 2-1, so it's only 2 more damage.
Oh, you're right. It's only 2 more damage.
I think he's going to double trade, too.
Oh, wow. Okay. So he's giving up that 4 for another 2. Okay, that's perfectly reasonable when you start analyzing it like that. Because I like keeping the coin for the flexibility of being able to Lava Burst next turn if needed. Cool Taskmaster to pick off this Tunnel Trog. So
that's a huge deal.
Yeah, these Tunnel Trog going down would have been so problematic. Have to imagine that Savitz feels really tempted just to draw cards right now. But you overload, so it's kind of a losing situation if you pick up a Doomhammer somewhere along the way.
I like the card draw. I don't think it's worth it to Lava Shock the 2-2. It just doesn't trade favorably against your board.
Yeah, the 2-2, what's it going to do? Just hit it into the 2-3 and then use another Cool Taskmaster. That's not efficient at all. Ancestral Knowledge definitely has a lot of gas to go into it. And the Doomhammer was picked up, so it's definitely not the happiest with how it panned out, but it's okay. At least he has a Doomhammer, one of the important cards against Warrior, in my opinion.
The only reason to trade here would probably be like a slam.
Yeah, I guess so, but he can also just slam the other one if you really want the card draw.
Yeah.
Black Wing Corruptor. Pretty nice. That's probably the best card that Tice could have drawn here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Tice is starting to reel it back into his side. I mean, he was so far behind going into some of those few turns. But now it's slowly edging towards the Warrior side.
Well, Shaman has 20 damage in the hand, assuming it could play it all in one turn. And Doomhammer, of course, adding 4 per turn. So he's not out of the woods just yet.
Mm-hmm.
Warrior will be playing the taunt and armoring up, but there's so much damage on the Shaman side. And Tice is just still so close to ending the game. Or ending the series, excuse me. As long as he can end this game, he can declare himself the winner. But the Warrior deck still seems like it's struggling a little bit these early game woes. The early game seems to be what ultimately betrays this deck.
Always little time. What do we have here?
Well, if you like Totem and you get a spell power, you can Lightning Bolt. And that does give you the option of keeping your mana for next turn so that you can play the Doomhammer.
Yeah, you can do Doomhammer and Lightning Bolt next turn, which is quite nice.
You don't have a dragon. Maybe this is the time you play the Emperor while you have a chance to breathe. But it's one of those false sense of security. He's holding 7 cards, one of them being the coin, and he just hero powered with 3 mana. Most likely he has another 3 mana card to play in some capacity. In fact, it's impossible that he doesn't have anything to play. So he knows that the Doomhammer must be coming up.
I like the Emperor, though. I mean, I was thinking some kind of more defensive clear play, but I think you're absolutely right in the fact that if you don't play the Emperor here, you're never going to get a chance to play it.
The problem with the Emperor, though, is that you miss out on hero powering, and I think Tice also might be in the mentality that he wants to hero power as much as possible. But he can't also he can't also equip the weapon, too, which is really annoying. He'd rather have all those things. Which is why Emperor might be one of those things to try to squeeze in. He's taking a super safe approach, even trading with a 1-1. Oh my god.
Yeah, Tice, I think, built this deck to outlast the Shamans.
Yeah. So he's going to Elemental Destruction. That gives him room to play Totem Golem, Coin, Lava Shock.
Yep.
And that'll allow him to set up a clean, fresh slate for Doomhammer to start going to town next turn. He still has an enormous amount of damage. 20 with the burn, but 24 with Doomhammer and 28 the turn afterwards. So he's going to really start to hope that this Totem Golem can start putting in the work as well.
And that Lava Shock was a triple innervate.
It's really sick. All right. Now. But is it too late? It's a lot of damage. Right now it's 16 damage?
Yeah, it's 16 that I see. Oh, and there's the replacement hammer.
Yeah, this is if you are afraid of the Harrison, but he's not. I'm sensing that the series is going to be tied and going to game 5. Unless Tice can somehow bring it back right now. He's even going for the lightning bolt.
No, I don't like that too much. Next turn is your last turn. I think it's better to be flexible with it. You play one mana now, but you have one mana last next turn, so it's the same thing. Well, if he does do armor up and then Twilight Guardian, he is alive.
Yeah, he's alive by 1 HP, unless the spell power totem rolls from the Shaman Hero power, allowing him to hit the Lava Burst for 6. That would kill off the warrior. So, we probably want to do that. The good thing is that you get to actually use the Fiery War Axe this turn and start hitting, because otherwise it's just sitting there doing nothing. But here's another bigger problem, is that you can't kill the Shaman before it's likely to pick up another piece of burn here. Oh my goodness.
Oh, that's going to be it. But I think that may have not been true. With a 5 mana True Heart and a 0 mana Shield Slam, you could have gained 6 armor next turn and Shield Slam for 6. So actually, the Emperor's second pick had a really big impact that game. And had there not been a lethal there, it's possible that Tice could have held on the entire game.
Oh no, Tice, I mean, he's so devastated, man. You see at the end of the game, he's just, you know, stressed out. He was up 2-0, now he's down 0. Now, oh, not down 0-2, but in the past two games, he's dropped it while being pretty close. And once again, this warrior deck, is it the reason he got here, or is it the reason he hasn't won already? It's one of the hardest things. Maybe it's a little bit of both.
Mm-hmm. Well, it is going to come down to Saviz's consistency on this priest. I think if Saviz draws well, the priest minions are just too big to be dealt with appropriately by this warrior deck, so we'll have to see. I think the range of draws on the priest are so vast that it's almost entirely based on that. Even though the warrior hasn't been very consistent either, it seems consistent enough. Shadow Ward Pain does deal with a lot of the dragons, though. It deals with the monkey as well.
Yep, that's right. You know, being able to deal with those early game minions is going to be such a big deal for the priest. You really need to be able to land that curve, because the priest hero power doesn't do anything. At least the warrior hero power still gains you life and ultimately synergizes with Shield Slam, but priest still has no benefit whatsoever if it doesn't have any minions.
Actually, I really like Saviz's hand here. He can do turn 4 Corruptor, turn 5 Corruptor, and he has a Shadow Ward Pain. For
the Life Binder. Yeah, the Pain answers the champion.
Does it?
It can. I mean, it depends on what you want. You can also pass, but that's 2 turns of taking this damage.
It's not about damage, I think it's about value. This warrior deck has no draw. It's all about the big minions.
Yeah, but you're giving it options to expand the board. So while I can understand, because Shadow Ward Pain has a lot of targets you can hit in this deck, the first that comes to mind is the Twilight Guardian, being very notable. But there's just going to be more pressure building up, and with that Arathi Weaponsmith draw, that's basically optimal lines of removal.
I think he's going to pass again.
Maybe he feels like he's going to.
Yep. Is the situation that he set up is if Tice plays something, he does Aquanai Circle. If Tice plays nothing, he wins the board with a coin, Corruptor, Savius just wins both ways. He can afford to take some damage.
The Twilight Guardian isn't killed by the circle combo with the Akanai Soul Priest. And I think Tice is really evaluating this, thinking, why isn't he doing anything? He's just passing. Even if he wasn't, passing on purpose for this, that he had no play, he definitely would be mindful of this combination. He knows that Akanai Soul Priest is a possibility here. It's still an unusual card given in the format, right? I'm not used to seeing this, but, yeah.
That, I am surprised.
A lot, man.
That is a really passive play. I thought he would circle.
It's okay. That's the best target Shadow Word Pain can hit. If you're saying it, you're playing for value. You're going to really outcard them. You're not anticipating that Warrior can kill you. I think he's really taking advantage of the fact that it's clear Warrior doesn't have a true burst finisher, like a true closer. It's got a lot of good starting pitchers, but no ace to finish it out.
What now?
Seeing as everything dies to a circle, I think it's in your best interest to play the Weaponsmith.
Well, one thing for sure is I don't want Tice to play the dragon. I've seen scenarios like this very recently.
Oh, we have.
Oh, no! He's not going to have a dragon! Oh, my gosh. All right, okay, here we go. The clear, the circle clear. It's okay, because this turn he's going to play the Weaponsmith anyways, right? He wasn't planning on playing the Corruptor. So he has two draws to get the dragon.
Yeah.
No! Okay.
There's Varian.
I get it. Azure Drake there was the best to replace. Well, it's like to build the pressure in case he's not actually saving for an Akanai play. And it also replaces itself. So for him, in his opinion, he was okay. Well, but this is the March Back of the Priest.
If he played the Weaponsmith first and the Azure Drake second, he could not lose his minion to the Corruptor, actually. So the Azure Drake would have actually stabilized the board this turn.
Yeah, that's also a good point, too. That's brutal, because the difference between keeping the Drake and not is huge. Bash is 4 damage.
Mm-hmm.
Shield Slam gets an extra +1. No dragon!
He still has a... Oh, yeah, no dragon.
So he has to bash, Shield Slam, and then I guess the Farseer is all that's remaining mana-wise.
What if he just armor up Shield Slams and then plays the Farseer? That seems all right.
That is true. You can get away with that as long as you don't have Power Word Shield and draw a card, but I don't think you care too much about that. The thing that is scary, though, is how much cards that Priest can draw and outcard you.
Yeah, you do know that these North Shards are particularly threatening in this deck. Saviz is running the Wild Pyromancers. He's running a lot of heal effects. It can really steamroll out of control. So you could even make that play and then just War Axe at the end.
Okay, so he does end up going for a full clear option, but he's dumping a lot of cards to do it. I guess the good news is that almost anything is answered by what Savitz plays. The only problem is that he doesn't have a dragon. Another valuable trade here. The Priest is just really marching on. It's like you said, using the health as a resource and playing conservative from the beginning. It was a great line that Savitz has taken.
That's a good card. That gives him the dragon he needs.
About time. End up paying off. But if he didn't, he would have been in a very similar situation as his teammate, Life Coach. Savice also, I think, plays 2 Entombs.
I think you're right.
So that means ultimately the dragons in the late stages of the game for Tice, assuming it goes to a point where neither player can kill each other, Tice will outgrind the Warrior by a big margin.
Depends on the North Shires, right? The North Shires can swing that in a huge direction. I'm pretty familiar with the Control Warrior versus Control Priest matchup. And typically, when I feel I'm in control, I just let the Priest draw with Northshire and usually end up winning the fatigue game. But I think Saviz is too smart to let that happen.
Yeah, he's definitely played his fair share as well of the matchups, particularly the Golden Monkey ones, the variants. Yeah. You play fatigue. I think everyone's really experimented with a lot. Man, Tice from this point, he's got to use variant to climb back into it. Azure Drake trying to see if he can dig for some other stuff and really keep up the card count. That's not bad at all.
Yep.
It does happen to weaken one of the minions within range of the Fiery War Axe. So either you choose the Pyre... I guess you probably put on the Azure Drake because the Pyromancer is going to die either way.
I like the Azure Drake a lot more. I would consider perhaps... I guess you can't do much about it. No, I thought you could heal. Never mind.
All right, let's go. Varian Wrynn, this is an actual real need for Varian.
Yep.
Whether you pull minions or draw cards, anything will do.
If he gets like Ysera, he's going to win the game. Nope.
Oh, man. Nope.
Oh!
And he drew his third card?
Slam.
Slam. That's so huge. Because now he can only play Sylvanas, but he can't actually guarantee a steal on it. No Entomb.
No, the only thing he can do is death his own Sylvanas and hope to get Ysera.
Is that really what it's come down to?
Well, it's happening pretty quickly here.
Well, okay. Oh my goodness. 50-50 to steal Ysera, which can completely turn around the tide.
Nope.
He steals Varian instead.
That's huge, because now Dream punishes Varian.
Yeah, that's right, because the variant has to be played again, and then that pulls really deep into the deck. But it's... Okay.
Oh, Justicar. I think Tice might have a fatigue game on lock.
Well, he's drawing with the slam, so he's still evaluating his plays. Brand Bronzebeard not really impactful here.
I feel Saviz's depression right now.
I mean, he was so close to making a comeback. He was down 0-2, and he's like, yes, I can do this against the Warrior. But, that 50-50 was such a big deal. But he also went for that risk because he knew that if he played Sylvanas and just Death Varian, for example, he's still in the same spot, but might be worse. However, don't discount the fact that Saviz can still get an Entomb off the top of his deck.
Welcome to the Grand Tournament Champion.
Saviz can't believe that Varian got bounced.
He's like, no, I don't want... You gave me the Varian! Usually the player who plays this is in the bad spot.
With as many spells as Saviz has, this really could be a big problem. It's all up on this, though. Oh, he's
on your sets!
And Entomb!
On Ysera now! And he's got an Entomb! I have no clue what's happening. He's got the Nightmare. Tice is saying well played because this is hilarious, not because he actually won.
Wow.
Now, Tice doesn't actually know how to deal with his opponent, Ysera, because he doesn't actually have the removal in mind for it.
Yeah, he might go face, and that is going to be a disaster because Saviz does have the bounce. He has the flash heals.
Would you want it any other way, Crypt, for the final game where Varian Wrynn decides to finally come off his throne and say, okay, guys, I hear you guys talking mad smack talk about me.
Yeah, man, he's playing with Ysera's everywhere. Look at that. What a player.
Varian Wrynn now reads Battle Cry, put Ysera from your deck onto the battlefield. Here's the big problem. We were saying Tice might have the edge to close it out in the fatigue, but Saviz also has cards like Entomb, which are fantastic for fatigue. But he's also dying! So does he have enough time? This is such a hard thing. Ysera Awakens is a really relevant card right now, Crypt, because damage
very,
really matters.
Alright, this is an extremely difficult play for Saviz. You also have to consider the fact that he got a North Shard and he has a Circle Heal. So he is capable of drawing every single card in his deck. So the possibilities here are almost endless. He basically has to go off of his deck list and consider every possible imaginable play in this situation.
He definitely needs to... I think he really hopes that he can get a North Shire, what's it called? The Arcanized Soul Priest, but he can't use that Circle of Healing anymore. So he's going to draw some cards. He's almost certainly going to Entomb. If he can get that, if he was able to get the Arcanine, maybe he could have also used some of that first.
He can Nightmare a Taunt to stop damage, by the way.
Oh, you're right. That's such a clutch move, because Nightmare kills at the beginning of your turn.
Yep.
Oh, I love it. So that stops some damage for now. Of course, Tice is pretty upset. He's looking pretty stressed. Fiery War Axe. Okay, Ysera Awakens does 5.
No, there's no way you could do that right now. Your options are basically to develop a weapon and nothing else. Do you want to develop a weapon? What do you
think? You can develop a weapon, hit into the Wormrest agent, Ysera Awakens, and then kill Varian, develop the Emerald Drig. But that also, I mean, maybe he feels like he wants to use the Fiery War Axe for 6 damage to the face. That's 11 over turns. I mean, Priest also drew a lot of cards. I want to get a count of how many cards we're actually at.
Priest has got like 5 cards at most, I think.
Okay, well, at this point, he needs to have something on the board and definitely needs to at least keep hitting the armor up because he's going to need as much health as possible. This is coming down to a pretty epic game. So Vice looks like he can almost stabilize, but he's picking up kind of weak cards here. And doesn't really necessarily want to draw too many more, but...
No, I think playing the Armorsmith is a huge mistake. Savis drew his whole deck. He does have exactly 5 cards. He drew his whole deck, so you know you're going to have your Armorsmith Cabald. The fact that your Armorsmith gets Cabald, I think, means that you can stabilize as the Priest. I think with the Armorsmith coming down, Savis has won this game.
That's a really good point, because now you can play for the fatigue.
Yeah.
But you're really far ahead of the card draw. This is the case where Warrior really wish it had some kind of execute. Because if you can execute Ysera, then Ysera Awakens has a chance to reset the board.
Mm-hmm.
Let me change your mind.
Cabal on the Armorsmith is so big, and Tice is losing grip very slowly from this game. And that Emerald Drake is really cool, but not really doing much here.
Alright, well, this Awakens is going to have a big impact on the board. But, Ysera won't die, and there's another Ysera in the deck.
Mm-hmm. There's 2 Yseras. There's Ysera Rai!
Yeah. There's a lot of armor from that Armorsmith. I think that was the turning point.
Because you can't actually burn your opponent anymore.
Yep.
What cards do you have? Okay, he needs Nefarian to pull Thoughtsteel. And Thoughtsteel will get Ysera in the hand. What do you think about that, Crip?
Oh, man. I don't know about that.
How about Nefarian into Entomb? There's a lot of steel cards left if he can survive that long.
Mm-hmm.
If he can survive that long. I mean, the fact is, Ysera even pulling any kind of minions, like Laughing Sisters, is pretty relevant, too.
Yeah.
A lot of board pressure.
I don't see how Tice wins this game. The last time I said that, the opponent disconnected, so I guess that could happen.
Not now, Crip! Holy Nova's not really it. You know, it's going so long without hitting the other Ysera, but it's perfectly fine. Savitz has got so many good cards ready in the bottom of his deck here. That Entomb has been so clutch. I think Tyze is basically on his, he only has like two turns, three turns maybe at most.
He's got an Onyxia though. I think if he draws Onyxia, there might be some hope.
Oh!
Is Onyxia up top! And there's no AoE clear.
Not anymore.
He used both circles. He used Shadow Word Death. He used Sylvanas. He used his Entomb.
He's got the Dream, but he's going to have to keep getting good Ysera parts for this to work.
But Ysera has, like, the Laughing Sisters. That Twilight Guardian might be useful to stop the Onyxia from direct attacking.
Mm-hmm.
But all these 1-1s are so annoying.
Yep, it's really hard to handle the whelps.
I must consider.
Would you kill the Onyxia and just take it really slow and play minions? Just trade both the 4-attack minions, play out the Twilight Guardians and the Laughing Sisters, and then you know you have Ysera as your final card. Or sorry, you have two cards remaining. I mean, there's a possibility for that.
Yeah. It looks really bad, but I think it's a good opinion.
I do like the idea of trying to grind it out. However, if Priest is hitting Fatigue much quicker than the Warrior is, based off its draws, then it's going to need to also heal itself. You have to definitely consider how much you want to heal, for sure.
Looks like Savi is going to try to go for an aggressive approach.
Okay.
Could work. Dream. Could absolutely work.
So he's going to try to see if he can draw something really nice here. Another Dream!
That's pretty good.
Just to keep the Onyxias bouncing. I mean, for Tyce though, Onyxia kind of left mini Boombots if you think about it. It's just like Boombots guaranteed do 3 damage.
Yeah, but those only did 6 damage total. That's nothing. Dr. Boom. Dr. Boom frowns on your statement.
If you ask.
Yeah. This is hilarious, though.
I just want to point out that 10 minutes ago, Crip, is when Ysera's was pulled out by the Varian Wrynn, followed by the Sylvanas, into Varian Wrynn pulling another Sylvanas because he dreamed it! What?
Good.
All right, well, they're still far away from being able to pressure for the kill because tank up is so strong, but Warrior has definitely missed a couple of armor ups here.
Mm-hmm.
And I think if you're going to go for that plan of, like, playing Dream, I think you really go for it again. Try to see if you can maximize one more turn. Poor Savitz has not drawn his other Ysera either. Because I think if he had the second Ysera and played Dream...
Well, it's
Dream,
his last card, right? He only has one card left.
How many cards does the Warrior have in this deck? How far is Tyce from 50? You got 5? It's plenty.
Five's a lot more than one.
Yeah, Priest will be so far into Fatigue. Not to mention that he has the tank up.
I must consider.
Among those 5 again is Nefarian. Which is a lot of... It's a huge weight.
Dude, I don't even understand anymore. Injured Blade Master... Like, anything that he puts out as, like, a reasonable-sized threat is also pretty significant. He's starting to play a little bit of the clear. I do like killing the Onyxia, though, for sure. Dream Ysera so you can get maximum value. He's running out of time. Oh, my goodness. Savitz ran out of time here. I think he wanted to play the 2 Twilight Whelps so we can get them onto the board. And now the board is vulnerable a little bit. Oh, did he get it out of time?
Looks like he missed the Drake. Yeah.
Okay. Not bad. It helps fill out the curve. So Azure Drake and the Fierce Monkey. You've got something you can tank up. So as yet to hit Nefarian. The Big Daddy.
No dragon
yet. I'm waiting
for
Nefarian to give us some real nice dessert to this awesome main course. Man. This has been delicious. It's been exquisite so far. Not even Ramsey could be too salty about this game.
Yeah, all that Tyce has to do is stall. I think this game might be reliant on Ysera Dreams.
Okay.
If he gets like awakens, then I think Saviz can maybe, like, if he gets like two nightmares and awakens, I think he can do like some crazy burst combo before he's dead.
Okay, Tice is keeping the Akunai alive because he doesn't want the Akunai to heal. Oh no, he didn't get the last tech! Ah! He messed up! No! Not like this! Why? Oh, after all we've been through, this is how it goes? He loses the fierce monkey and Tice is regretting everything right now. Oh my goodness. A second too late might have costed him a big opportunity. It's not that the game's over, but the advantage has been definitely given more over to Saviz, and that's rattled Tice a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Emperor's note, not really anything here.
That's a decent Ysera pull, by the way, the Emerald Drake.
Okay. I don't know if we're going to act at that point, if the fatigue is actually going to matter. So in five turns, Priest will take 15 damage and it can't heal. So if it can last that long, I don't think it will, though.
Watch this be like a Nefarian Holy Smite to the face lethal.
So sick! Oh, I would love it. I would love it if that was the case. You know, realistically, it might also be the thing where, like, you want to suicide your own Akunai so you can start healing. Wait, is that two fatigue damage? I was.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I was miscounting. I was pretending as if he was taking one next turn. So...
No, it is one. It is one.
It was one? Oh, okay, my bad. I miscounted then. So he takes 15 in five turns, so he needs to kill the...
He doesn't have to kill the Tharson is the thing. He doesn't have to.
Right. But I'm saying he should probably consider killing his own Akunai if he wants to heal, or if he wants to be more proactive on the board, keep the Akunai alive, and then use it to fight as minion combat. Okay, Sabit's also roping. He's going to use this ping. And it looks like he's trading it in. Okay, I like it. I think you definitely just want to play the keep awake, because the fatigue is definitely against you and you need to heal. Your Sarah Awakens is also very dicey.
Is it Nefarian? Is it Nefarian?
No.
No.
It's pretty bad.
That's pretty bad.
He's also going to try to hit to accelerate the fatigue. To the face! I like it! Oh, this is coming down so close, Crip. 3 damage next turn. Oh, sorry, 2 damage, my bad. 3 damage the following turn.
He has to heal.
Here. I don't know if he has enough time.
He has
to draw double Nightmare this turn, I think. Something like that. I think he's just going to go for it. He has to go for a huge amount of burst. Because I think he still has the opportunity to get the Ysera Awakens for the finish, or maybe even a tie?
Oh, it's 10 damage.
Nefarian has... Wait.
No, it's not.
He's the bash! He got bash! That's it! That's enough damage, right?
Is it? No, it's 2.
It's 2 damage.
It's only 2.
Are you sure?
Oh, it's 3!
Hammer down! Here's the end!
Job's done.
What was that?
2 Yseras is not good enough.
That's the grand finals, Tice is the champion! Sabiz can't believe it! We're in shock! They're still stunned! We have their cameras right here! That was insane!
I swear I saw Nefarian played by that warrior deck before. I don't know. Maybe they switched it up a little bit.
I don't know,
like maybe,
man.
Maybe some of them are playing Nefarian, maybe some aren't. Whatever. Yeah, that was mind-blowing.
That was a climax that lasted 20 minutes. And I will never know what it's like to feel something like that again. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, what a relief that Tice got the win there. Because if he would have lost by the slightest margin, he would have blamed himself forever for that missed attack with the 1-1.
I mean, and the same thing too. Like, it's one of those things. Okay, I kind of was in the zone where, like, Saviz probably couldn't win the game, but if he had so much damage, he could have maybe tied the game.
Mm-hmm.
If that wasn't Bash as the last card. We were expecting Nefarian for the longest time. I think it's because life.
The regame on that one? Oh, God. We've been here all through the night.
Oh my goodness.
Warrior goes through all the way to the end. How about that?
Speechless.
Yeah. Great stuff. Well, Tice does take it. He is taken home. It's about $13,000 for first place, but certainly all the glory, especially after that.
Yeah, that was quite the photo finish there. Not quite the like one damage over fatigue end up being the lethal where they both end up passing, but pretty dang close. All 30 cards were drawn from both decks, and you wouldn't want to go either way. From all the swings from the Varian Wrynn, we've mocked him enough, but he ended up being a super player for both teams there. Yep. Also, shout out to Savitz for bringing a really good amount of decks, really being able to mix it up with that priest. Love it. Love it a lot. Thank you so much, everybody who's tuned in. I believe this concludes our programming. We want to give some final shout outs to everybody. But before we do, Crypt, do you have anything you want to say about the event before we dismiss?
Not too much. It was really interesting to see kind of like a sneak peek on what the standard format might be like. Okay, of course, we knew the Druids will dominate and all that. But in the end, the very decisive matches were like Priest and Warrior games. So, you know, that actually probably is a pretty good sneak peek on what we can expect in the future of Hearthstone. And, well, unless something drastic happens, the future looks pretty bright.
Yeah, collectively, the Hunters are weeping everywhere around the world right now, as they have not had any representation. But don't worry, the Shamans will live on in its former glory, at least for now. Until then, this has been Frodan and Crip bringing you guys the Curse Trials presented by Team Archon. A big final shout-out and thank you to everyone who helped make this happen, including geekfield.com. Check out their link. It's /Team Archon, so that way you guys can get up to $50 worth of swag in every one of those packages that they present. A big shout out to the Curse Network for help sponsoring the event as a whole, along with their subsidiary network of Hearthpwn.com. And finally, the Innkeeper.com. What they do is help you manage all your collection, your cards, in case you want to build meta decks. Make sure just at least take a look and see if you like the tool. And if you do, you can incorporate it into how you play your Hearthstone. Until then, we're done. Until next time, it's been real. It's been fun. It's been real fun. Have a good night.
Thanks for watching.